Rosemary Banyard, the fund manager of the VT Downing Unique Opportunities Fund, joins us here on Proactive London this afternoon to discuss what's been a challenging period for markets and how you've managed the fund throughout this unprecedented time. Rosemary, great to see you. So how has the portfolio, how has it performed since the launch in March 2020?
Quite fortuitously, the fund launched, as you say, in March 2020, which turned out to be the bottom of the market after people sort of got very worried about the early beginnings of COVID. So it was a great time to launch. Lots of companies that I wanted to invest in were looking very attractive at that time. Mm. And so I bought pretty well all the companies that I'd planned to do in the run-up to the launch. The fund's done pretty well. So I think if we go to the end of 2021, the fund is up something like 75% from launch. But admittedly, you know, launch was at a low point. So what does the industry say? The past isn't necessarily a guide to the future. Let's just say that. I'd say that in the last couple of months, life has been a bit rockier, as you say, for the markets, and we're not immune to that. I've been carrying about 10% cash really quite a while, and that reflects the fact that some of the companies that I'd like to add to have got bid up quite a long way. And so a setback is from my point of view an opportunity to add to good businesses at more attractive prices. I think there's people are obviously worried at the minute about inflation and staff shortages, and also about maybe availability of product from China because of the COVID that's starting to emerge there. So there's lots of worries, but then there are always worries.
Yeah, and volatility was a recurring theme throughout 2021. And I believe the most challenging period for the fund was between sort of late September through to October time. How did you manage to kind of steer through that sticky time?
Well, as I say, I've had sort of some cash holdings for a while, and so that does itself dampen volatility. Beyond that, I would say that the companies that I own are trading well. So I think that the panic that we're seeing is not actually based on, if I could say, evidence of underlying business concerns. I'd go slightly further. I mean, since the beginning of January, we've had a few companies in the fund that have made announcements, and they've been positive. There have been upgrades. So there's sort of fear out there, but reality isn't quite so bad.
And what do you invest in, and what do you avoid?
So I very much focus on quality in businesses. If we take the portfolio as a whole, there are certain characteristics which point to that. So the first point is that there are 33 holdings, and only five of them have any debt at all. Right. So the vast majority of the companies I invest in have cash on the balance sheet. That's positive because, firstly, if interest rates go up, they'll earn more on the cash. Secondly, it gives them options, so they can invest in expansion. They can choose to buy back their shares. They can pay special dividends. They can even go and make acquisitions, although not all of them will wish to do that. So it's a quality portfolio. The margins, the average margin of profit margin of companies in the fund is high. It's well over 20% mm-hmm. at the net level. Again, that tells you that these companies have got barriers to entry. They're keeping out the competition. Mm-hmm. And the third characteristic of the fund is that the companies earn high returns on equity capital. Yep. Often that's because they don't have much fixed capital. They're what's known as capital light. So the average return on equity in this fund is over 30%, which is very high. And that means that these companies should weather inflationary times quite well, because they haven't got to put a lot of money into working capital as prices go up. Mm-hmm. And they haven't got to replenish stock at higher prices. They can afford to do it, but they probably don't have much stock, actually. And I guess the fourth characteristic is an interesting one, which is that the average holding by directors in these companies is nearly 10%. Mm-hmm. So there's a lot of skin in the game in this portfolio by the people that run the businesses actually owning the businesses.
Mm-hmm. So four characteristics that you look out for and, you know, demand. What do you avoid then?
Yes, sorry, you did ask. So I tend to avoid companies that have got weak balance sheets, lots of debt. I think they're always vulnerable to rising interest rates or deteriorating business conditions. There are certain sectors that I'm not fond of and tend to avoid. So one is resources, both mining and oil and gas. And this is because once you've mined something or taken the oil out, there's just a hole in the ground. There's nothing left. So it's a one-off investment, if you like, a one-off revenue. And then you've got to go and hunt for some more. Mm. Whereas I like businesses which sell something several times over, many years over. So say a software company, they'll sell you a license, but then next year they'll come back and say, oh, and we want another year's license fee. Thank you very much. So I prefer those businesses. They're better businesses. And then another area that I'm not so keen on are the banks. They're very popular at the moment because when interest rates are going up, obviously they charge the borrowers more quite quickly, but they don't pay the depositors more so quickly. So they see a margin increase, but it's still a very low margin. And they lend out, your and my deposits 10 times over to achieve a decent return. So I view them as rather opaque. We don't know what hedges they've got in place. We don't know when the companies they lend to are going to get into difficulties or not. So I tend to avoid that area as well.
Mm-hmm. And in conclusion, I see that you've quoted Warren Buffett in your article piece. So be fearful when others are greedy and greedy when others are fearful. Do you have your own motto that you live by?
I can't honestly say that I have a snappy one like that. I commend Buffett and Charlie Munger actually to you. Munger is often not as well known, but there are some books that you can get hold of with the sayings of both men, and I have to say I think they're both well worth a read. There's lots and lots of sayings. I can't better them.
Oh, well, they are good ones. They are particularly good. Rosemary, great to meet you. Thank you very much indeed. The fund manager of the VT Downing Unique Opportunities Fund here on Proactive London, introducing us to what you do there and some of your operations over the period from March 2020.
Pleasure.